I'm right in the middle of the Capture One tutorials. Now I gotta stop and do this thing. Hi everyone and welcome to PaltaTech. Fujifilm just announced that they have upgraded and released their new webcam software version 2.0. Apparently, this new upgrade allows you to adjust your film simulation, your white balance, your exposure. We gotta check this out. Okay, so the first thing you wanna do is head over to the webcam download software website. I'll have a link to that down below in the description of this video. There are versions for both Windows and Mac. I'm gonna demo this on a Mac. No insult to the PC Windows users. I just don't have time to get a PC set up right now. It's in the other room. Go ahead and install the software, and it will require you to restart your Mac once it's finished installing. Now we wait for the computer to restart. This is a hard channel to run, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, it's back on. For this demo, I'm gonna use a Fujifilm X-T3, but you can certainly use any Fuji X compatible camera. I'm gonna go ahead and put this just on a tripod. Okay, so there's no flippy screen to see myself, so what I'm gonna do is just use this little mirror device. This is very cool. I will have a link to it in the description below. Put it right on top of the camera, then you flip the screen kind of up like this, maybe to there, something like that. All right, turning the camera on. There is also a handy guide from Fujifilm that explains the various settings you should use when setting this up. To keep this video short, I'm not gonna go through each one of those, but I will have a link to that document down below. Make sure that you read it before you start using this webcam software. Okay, so I have tried every setting I could think of on this camera, including following the instructions from Fuji, and it's not working. Okay, I have a different cable here. Let's try this one out. Why is this not working? Okay, so I restarted the computer, but I ran into a problem. When I opened up the app, this is what I got. It was just blank, and I fiddled and fiddled with the camera. I couldn't make it work. If you, like I did, see this kind of blank webcam thing where it doesn't look like it's controlling the camera in any way, what you need to do is first open up whatever software you're going to be using to run the webcam through, whether it's Zoom, Skype, OBS, and so forth. Now you see Zoom is open, but nothing's happening. What you need to do is go into that software's preferences, go into video, and watch this. See, you see that right there? Do you see what just happened? The webcam was recognized by the Fuji software only at the point at which the other software recognized it. This is really an important point because normally what I do is I connect the Fuji camera and suddenly it's recognized and then I go and I do my webcast or whatever. So here's what I'm gonna do just to test out that little problem again. I'm gonna completely close Zoom. So the camera, the Fujifilm camera, is connected to the Mac, right? Now, if I go and I open up the webcam software from Fuji, nothing happens. It looks like nothing happens. Fuji, what you really need to do is have some kind of a message that says, you know, waiting for software to connect or waiting to connect to software, something that tells the user that you need to do more than just open this up to check it. Because right now, looking at this, this tells me it seems like the camera's not connected. So it's a usability issue, but it confused me and I do this stuff all the time. I can only imagine, you know, some people who don't do this a lot would be really confused by this. So now I'll launch OBS just for the heck of it. Nick, did you see it come on? Check it out, see that? Now it's working and this is good. Okay, now that I got all that out of the way, let's test it out. There's a digital zoom feature, which is kind of nice. Okay. Ah, right? So you can do a little digital zoom. You can change, I love this part. You can change film sims right here. So let's go to black and white. All right, hey, how about that? Pretty cool. White balance, this is nice. Look, they got custom 1, 2, and 3. So what you can do is you can set your custom white balance ahead of time on the camera and then choose that custom white balance from the Fuji software. All right, let's try color temperature. And let's change the, look at that. Let's go to 10,000 Kelvin. Ah, it's so hot in here. That's kind of nice. I mean, look, if you're just doing a typical online webcast, I would probably just put it in auto. All right, back to auto, there it is. And this is nice, exposure compensation. You can turn that up or down. So I'm gonna turn it up, three. This is probably my favorite feature of the software is the exposure compensation, because so many times when you're doing a Zoom meeting or a webcast, you need to just bump it up a little bit. And in the past, I've had to purchase third-party applications. But now for this, I don't really need it because this can zoom, this can do auto white balance, auto exposure lock. Bottom line here, I think this version 2.0 is awesome. Fuji, you did a great job on it. But it's very confusing when you first install it. I thought I didn't do it correctly. I spent about half an hour with different cords, different settings, and then it dawned on me what I need to do is maybe open up Zoom or Skype. And once I did that, it activated the webcam software. So I don't know, maybe a message or something, or you know, I need extra help, okay? Anyhow, thank you so much for watching. Go check this software out. And just because I did a video today doesn't mean you're not getting a fast Friday tomorrow. Oh, you're getting a fast Friday tomorrow, and it's gonna be fast and awesome. Yeah, I'll see you then. Take care. Oh, another software update. When can I ever turn on the computer and just wanna get something done without a software update? Can, for my birthday this year, Apple and every other software vendor, for my birthday, don't do any software updates. I just want one day where I can get on the computer and not have to stop what I'm doing to do a software update.